What's up? Medite here, and in this video, we're going to talk about the superficial and the deep muscles of the thorax. Now, depending on the source you're studying from, muscles of the thorax can be divided into three groups. The first group are the superficial muscles of the thorax, or also called the thoracohumeral muscles, because they act on the upper limb movement. These are the subclavius, serratus anterior, pectoralis minor, and pectoralis major. Then we have the deep muscles of the thorax, which are also called the proper muscles of the thorax, because they both originate and insert in the thorax. These are the external intercostal muscles, internal intercostal muscles, subcostal muscles, transverse thoracis, and then the levator costarum. The third group is the diaphragm. It's also considered as a muscle of the thorax. We're not going to talk about the diaphragm in this video. There's going to be a separate video about this one. So, in this video, we're first going to talk about the four superficial muscles, and then do the five deep muscles in the thorax. Awesome. So the subclavius muscle is located here. It's subclavius, so it's under the clavicle. It originates at the first rib, as you see here, and it inserts at the lower surface of the clavicle. So when this muscle contracts, it stabilizes the clavicle by pulling it downwards. Next, we have the serratus anterior muscle. These are large muscle fibers located on the lateral aspect of the first to the ninth rib. So it originates from the external surface of the ribs 1 to 9, and it inserts at the medial border of the scapula, back here. And just to visualize it better, here you see a superior view of it. You see it goes back and attaches to the medial margin of the scapula. And when they contract, they pull the medial margin of the scapula forward, which help flex the arm. So that's the serratus anterior. Next is the pectoralis minor. The pec minor is located here. It originates from the external surface of the third to the fifth rib, and it inserts at the carotid process of the scapula. And when they contract, they pull the shoulders down and medially. Stiffness in this muscle can harm your pose by bulging your shoulder forward, so make sure you stretch this muscle as well whenever you can. Alright. Next is the pectoralis major, which is here. Fibers from this muscle are divided into three parts according to where they originate from. We have the clavicular part, which originates from the clavicle, sternocostal part, originating from the sternum and the costal cartilage, and the abdominal part, which originates from the abdominal muscles. And they all unite and insert at a common place, which is the crest of the greater tubercle, as you see here. This is the crest of the greater tubercle of the humerus. So that was it for the superficial muscles of the thorax. Next, we have the deep muscles of the thorax. And the first one are the subcostal muscles. These are muscles located on the inside of the thorax on the back here. So let's focus on this area and zoom in to see them better. All the muscle fibers of the subcostal muscles originate from the lower rib and they insert on the upper rib. And when they contract, they pull the thorax downwards to aid with expiration, so they are part of the expiration muscles. Then we have the transverse thoracis muscle, located here. It originates from the internal surface of the sternum, the xiphoid process, and the cartilage of the 4th to the 7th rib, and they insert at the cartilage of the 2nd to the 6th rib. They also pull the chest downwards to aid with expiration. Then there's the internal intercostal muscles, which are here between the ribs. These muscles originate from the lower rib and they insert into the upper rib, and when they contract, they will pull the chest down to aid with expiration. Superficially to the internal intercostal muscles are the external intercostal muscles. They originate from the upper rib and they insert at the lower rib. So these muscles are going to elevate the thorax to help with inspiration, expanding the thoracic cavity to bring the air in. After that, we have the levatores costarum muscles. These are tiny muscles on the backside here and are divided into two groups. First, we have the levatores costarum brevis, which are short levatores costarum. They originate from the transverse processes of C7 to T11 and insert one rib below. So they're short because they don't skip any ribs. The other one is the levatores costarum longi. These ones originate from the T8 to T11 and insert two ribs below. They're longer because they skip one rib completely and then insert two ribs below. And when they contract, they also pull the thorax up to aid with inspiration. So That was the muscles of the thorax, and I hope that was helpful.